Hey, I'm Andy Alidort, and in the second edition of History of Rock, I'd like to talk about two of the most important blues musicians that ever lived that were huge influences on the development of rock music, and that would be John Lee Hooker and Elmore James. John Lee Hooker, born August 22nd, 1912, or 1917, and died June 21st, 2001, was one of the most essential blues musicians and guitarists that ever lived. His music and guitar playing influenced everyone from the Rolling Stones to Jimi Hendrix and ZZ Top, and he recorded with a variety of rock musicians through his long career. Tease Me is one of his most famous songs.
You can't tease me.
A signature element of John Lee Hooker's style, especially in the early recordings like those that he did for the Modern record label starting in 1949, is that he tuned to an open tuning, usually open G or open A. Tease Me is played in open A with a capo at the second fret. Without the capo, the notes would be E, A, E, A, C sharp, E. With the capo, F sharp, B, F sharp, B, D sharp, F sharp. He picks with his fingers and he plays something along the lines of this. Let's take a look at one of his most famous and influential compositions, Boogie Chillin'.
Well, my mama, she didn't love me. Yeah, to stay out all night long. Oh, Lord.
John Lee uses the same tuning for this song, open A tuning with a capo at the second fret. And the signature part of the lick is that you got this rolling figure. It starts from the second fret and then the fourth fret. So it's like this. This lick and song would be extremely influential on Johnny Winter's Mean Town Blues. I asked him about it once, and I said, it sounds a lot like Boogie Chillin', and he said, yeah, it wasn't supposed to be intentional. So now let's take a look at Elmore James.
Shake your money maker, shake your money maker, shake your money maker, shake your money maker, and then Shake your money maker. 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 And then shake your money maker, shake your money maker, baby, you gotta shake your money maker, shake your money maker, you gotta shake your money maker, and then
Elmore James was hugely influential on so many different rock musicians. The band Fleetwood Mac, the original Fleetwood Mac with Peter Green and Jeremy Spencer. Jeremy Spencer really was the Elmore James freak, and they based his whole style on that. And in fact, Brian Jones from the Rolling Stones, he originally called himself Elmo Blues right when the Rolling Stones were forming. And then as a slide guitar player, he influenced every slide guitar player that came after him, which would be, you know, Duane Allman and Johnny Winter and really everyone. Jimmy Page, Jeff Beck, anybody picked up a slide. John Lee Hooker played in an open tuning, as I said, usually G or A, and Elmore played in an open tuning too, which slide guitar players often do, and he often played an open D. So this guitar is an open D, Shaker Moneymaker is an open D. D, A, D, F sharp, A. History of Rock, I'm Andy Allidort. See you next time.